Welcome. I'm Morris Mohammed, and you're watching the English news program on Somaliland National Television. Now, these are the headlines. The President of Somaliland sends a congratulatory message to Somaliland's forces. Somaliland Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance holds a press conference. Student detained after killing two people in Moscow school shooting. President of Somaliland Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silania, while in London, UK, sent a recorded congratulatory message to the military forces of Somaliland on their 20th anniversary. On his congratulatory message, the President of Somaliland Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silania said, "Today, on the 20th anniversary of our forces, I congratulate Somaliland's forces wherever they are, and their families as well, on this important day. We are very proud of our forces and we are proud of their existence because they protect Somaliland and its people, and we have to congratulate you for your anniversary. Somaliland's military forces were established 20 years ago, and the President of Somaliland Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silania and former President Mohamed Ibrahim Egal were key figures who took part of establishing Somaliland's forces. Somaliland's military forces anniversary is celebrated every year on the 2nd of February. Each year the president makes a speech to the national forces, but this year, due to his trip to UK, he sent a recorded message specially to congratulate the forces. And the vice president of Somaliland, Abdurrahman Abdullah Ismail Sayli'i, who's acting the president constituently while the president is outside the country on a business trip, made the speech to the forces this year in the celebration. Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance held a press conference in his office and discussed several issues. Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance Abdullahi Muhammad Dahir Akuse provided information to the media regarding the government's viewpoint on the media law, which SONSAF organization is currently discussing with senior journalists in Somaliland to prepare for the implementation of a media law. The Minister Abdullahi Dahir Akuse also spoke on the press conference about the interferences from neighboring country Somalia and stated that such deeds are unacceptable. On the other hand, the Minister announced that the Ministry of Information cancelled the working license of Universal TV after disrespecting the government and the people of Somaliland, which was an endurable deed to the sovereignty of Somaliland. The minister, on the other hand, announced that the government of Somaliland is planning to take Universal TV in front of the justice. Somaliland Minister of Fisheries and Marine Resources Ali Chamah Farah refuted allegations about his ministry published by some media institutions on a press conference at his office. The Minister of Fisheries and Marine Resources on a press conference at his office clarified that it's impossible to receive delegations from neighboring country Somalia to participate in any meeting regarding the improvement of the Ministry of Fisheries. The Minister also rejected the false news published by some media institutions. He urged the media to restrain from such destructive statements. Also, the Minister of Fisheries elaborated further on the current conflict between him and the Director General of the Ministry, stressing that these conflicts are minor and business-related. However, no concerns should be made around this issue. Somaliland's Vice Minister of Public Works and Housing, Ali Abdi Sayek, announced that his ministry stopped the import of public transport vehicles with a door on the left side to Somaliland for passengers' safety measures. The minister on his speech stressed and urged authorities of Berbera Port and Customs to refuse the import of any public transport vehicles with a door on the left side. The minister elaborated on the danger it has on passengers' lives on roads and that using a vehicle with a door on the roadside increases accidents on roads. Thus, it's unsafe for the lives of citizens. The Minister of Public Works and Housing explaining the measures needed to be taken for the safety of the passengers also urged the public transport buses already working in Somaliland that has a left-sided door to change the doors to the right side during the next 3 months. Director General of the Ministry of Public Works and Housing also spoke at the event and mentioned that license tax revenues for vehicles imported to Somaliland was lowered. Eventually, participants speaking at the event also welcomed the new plans of the Ministry of Public Works regarding vehicles and licenses. Director General for the Ministry of Finance, on an exclusive interview with SLN TV, elaborated on their working plan for the year 2014-2015. The Director General of the Ministry of Finance, on an exclusive interview he granted our reporters, announced that the increase of taxes is part of their working plan for the year 2014-2015. He also mentioned training programs to be implemented for the staff of the Ministry of Finance. While speaking of the Ministry's future plans, the Director General stated that most finances are generated from taxes by Berbera Port and Calabait. However, this year we are planning to increase inland revenue taxes, which are also known as direct taxes, which is the main source that budgets are internationally based on, he said. The Director General for the Ministry of Finance spoke about the importance of the direct taxes and the disadvantages of indirect taxes, which are the custom revenue. He also stated that telecommunication companies are the main areas in which indirect taxes are not fully paid. You're still watching the English news program on Somaliland National Television. And now for the international headlines. A Russian student has been detained after shooting dead a teacher and a police officer at a high school in Moscow. The gunman surrendered shortly after taking more than 20 other students hostage in a biology classroom. Authorities say he was armed with a rifle he obtained from his father, who helped police convince the teenager to give himself up. The drama took place at school number 263 on the northern outskirts of the Russian capital. The shooting sent dozens of students scurrying out the school while a police helicopter landed in a snow-covered field outside. It comes despite a widespread rise in security just days before the start of the 2014 Winter Olympics in the Black Sea Resort city of Sochi. The interim president of the Central African Republic, Catherine Samba-Panza, has visited a refugee camp outside the country's capital, Bangui, and vowed to secure the city one neighborhood at a time. While she gave words of encouragement to just a small percentage of the tens of thousands of children who have fled sectarian violence in the country, international forces reportedly took charge of the rebel-controlled city of Sibut. Just 180 kilometers from Bangui, the strategic center had been in the hands of the militia alliance, SILICA. The African-led international mission known as MISEC. The African-led international mission known as MISCA and backed by French forces entered the city on Friday in an attempt to put an end to the crisis. Around 1 million people have fled their homes and more than 1,000 lives have been taken in the month of violence in the Central African Republic. That's all the news. Thank you for watching. You can join us tomorrow at the same time.